Hi, first grade. Today I'm going to teach you how to create an illustration with a zoom-in box. Remember what zoom-in boxes are? Zoom-in boxes are a picture or an illustration that zooms in to show the reader a closer view of an object. Like in this example right here, here's the moon. They might be writing a paper about the moon, like we're writing about animals. And they zoomed in this part of the moon right here, and they did a picture that looks like that's what the surface of the moon looks like. The moon is so far away, we can't really see it. So they did a zoom-in box to show us exactly what's going on the surface of the moon. Let's look at another example. This one is a book about trees. And in this book, in this picture, there's a big tree that's kind of far away. So they zoomed in to show us what those leaves look like really close. In this one, they even added a caption to give us more information. So this caption says, "The thin tubes inside leaves are called veins. Veins carry water and food." You guys, their caption has twin sentences, doesn't it? That's pretty impressive. They did two zoom-in boxes on this one. This is the roots. So they told us roots grow underground. They look like this. And that's pretty helpful because we can't see underground, can we? So we don't know what the roots look like. And they gave us a picture of that. Well, I think we should try it in our animal books. So the first thing is, I want you to think of one part of your animal that you might like to highlight. It could be something that's really unique about your animal that isn't true for other animals, or it could be something that you can't see from far away, so you want to give your reader a closer look. Like, here's my example. Beavers have orange teeth. Did you know that? I had no idea they had orange teeth. I've seen many pictures of beavers, but I've never really noticed that they have orange teeth. But they do. I found that out in my research. So I found this picture right here on the internet of a beaver, and you can't really see his teeth in this picture, but he's eating something. So I chose this picture because he's eating, and I'm going to add his teeth into this picture. So I'm going to use this photo to draw my illustration. All right, here's step one. The first thing, just like with the other illustrations, you're going to sketch your animal with a pencil, a regular pencil, not a colored pencil and not a crayon and definitely not a marker. But we want to just sketch lightly with a regular pencil so we can erase. I had to erase many times. In fact, if you look closely right here, do you see this line? Yeah, I made his back way too big and he kind of looked like his head was sitting in a giant egg. But I erased it and it still doesn't look like the picture exactly, but that's okay. I did my best and I forgot the rest. And that's what you can do too. Then I also put my zoom in box and I kind of opened up his mouth so you could see those big front teeth there. And I drew a line showing to where they'd be. You could see I kind of added them into the drawing too to give my reader an example right there. All right, so that's step one. Then step two, you're gonna fill it in with some color. Don't forget to trace the outlines and make it pop out. I used a black colored pencil on mine and I made it really stand out and look nice. And then you see I added his little tongue in there and his teeth. And I kind of imagined what it would be like with his mouth opened. And I put him eating a leaf. Now you'll notice that my picture matches the words. So it says beavers are mammals. They have long, sharp teeth. Their teeth are orange because their body produces iron to keep their teeth strong. So my picture right there matches the words on the page. You might want to take a peek at the words on your page and see if you can create a zoom-in box that highlights some information that you're sharing with your reader on that page. The next step is fill in that background. It makes it look so pretty and really fills the page. And a lot of times when we read books, when we look at our mentor text, the page is full of color to make it more appealing to the reader that makes them think that it's a really high quality book. So I just sketched around and did blue It was actually supposed to be water, because back in my picture I was looking at, he was standing on the bank of a river, but it looked more like sky, but that's okay. So I just went with it, and I added some grass all around, and I put two colors of green in there to kind of give it some variation, because grass isn't always one color. So I kind of wanted to make it a little varied. Then the next step is, if you have some room, you can add a caption. I put a caption on mine to tell my reader what made the teeth orange. I wrote, "Iron makes the beaver's teeth orange." I didn't have a ton of room, so I just wrote a really short caption, but then it explains it a little more in my chapter 2 words. All right, it's your turn. Now you can try it. You can pause the video and create an illustration with a nice zoom in box. Good luck. All right, did you do it? Yeah. So take a photo of your fabulous work. We cannot wait to see your Zoom inbox and how you did it. Upload it to Google Classroom so that your teacher can see exactly what you did today. Way to go, first grade. You are doing an awesome job.